Another minimum cost span activity method is Kruskal. So here also write same thing. Here also the Kruskal will be take the input as a graph, or you can simply write the definition like this graph. Then output should be minimum cost spanning tree. Minimum cost spanning tree. Okay, spanning tree in the sense the tree doesn't having any cycles or loops. If the tree is going to form a cycle, that edge is ignored. Take alternative another edge which is not to be form a cycle. Okay, then go to procedure how this algorithm is work to find the minimum cost spanning tree. So let us take procedure. Here also select minimum cost. The first step is common in the both the cases, minimum cost edge. Second step is a slightly difference. This is the major difference between Kruskal and Prim's algorithm. The second point will be shows the difference between Kruskal and Prim's. In Prim's algorithm, we are select only visited vertices adjacent list, but here take any of the edge which is the minimum, next minimum of the graph. Here select next minimum cost edge from the graph. This is a very very important point. This is the point only differ Prim's and Kruskal. Okay, even though they have connected to adjacents or not, if it is a minimum, next minimum of this you can take that wherever it is. Next, this is the procedure. This is continue until to find all minimum cost edges. Here the finally what is the final step? All nodes are visited only once or exactly once, and graph should be loop free. That means no cycles in the graph. So this is the procedure is involved in the Kruskal algorithm to find the minimum cost spanning tree. So let us take example how this implementation is happening. Let's look at on same example which is discussed in the Prim's algorithm to find the minimum spanning tree. So take same example how to find a minimum cost spanning tree using Kruskal. What is the first step? So take visited list as is work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Initially the state is 1 because of we are not yet to be visited that node. Okay. So first point is in the procedure take the minimum edge. Among this graph minimum cost is 5. So take 1 and 6 connect edge with the cost is 5. So here the advantage of Kruskal is take next minimum from the graph wherever it is located. Wherever it is present, then take simply the next minimum edge of this graph. So next minimum after 5, next minimum is among these edges is 6. So take this 2, 1, 7, the cost is 6. So visit as it is. If it is visited, 1 is visited, state is 1, 6 is visited, state is 1, 2 visited, state is 1, 7 is visited, state is 1. So next, after 5 and 6 edges, next minimum edge is, what is the minimum edge? 9 is in between of 2 and 3. Okay, 3 is visited. Next edge is 10. 10 is 3 to 4 edge. So 4 is visited. Next edge is 7 to 5. Next minimum edge is 7 to 5. Okay, 5th node is visited. So all the nodes are visited, but still it is not connected. One edge is lagging. Okay, so where we want to connect? What is the next minimum edge? 12. Suppose if you connect 12, it is form a cycle. This is totally separated. Okay, so that this is not a correct edge to connect. So what is the next minimum edge after 12? Next minimum edge is 13. Suppose if you connect the 13, it is form a loop. These are separated. Okay, so our goal is the final graph should be loop free. That is, there is no cycle, there is no loops. So after 13, next minimum edge is either 25 or 18. But compared to 25, 18 is a minimum. So then 18 is connected. So all the nodes are visited and all the nodes are connected to each other. So finally, the subgraph is minimum cost planning tree is find out from the graph. So total cost is 8, 11, 6, 9, 10. So it is also 59. So either you can use Prim's algorithm or Kruskal algorithm on the same graph, the cost should be same. So this is the two techniques, important techniques to find the minimum cost spanning tree from the graph.